Hello and welcome to another episode of This Week in Cognitive. I'm your host, Noella Sherity, and today I'm going to be talking to you about something that was announced just a couple weeks ago. We recently decided, Satya at our developer conference this year announced how important it was for us to start looking at all of these pre-built models and really kind of increasing the ability for you to leverage them. So some of the complications we've run into is that we have companies that really want to use these models, but they're in very strange locations. So for example, maybe someone's in space, right? And in the space station, they want to be able to run models. You know, if you're in the space station or outside of our, you know, stratosphere, it might be pretty difficult for you to hit a cloud service running in a data center in the US or in Europe. So how can we make it easier for those types of solutions to get access to this technology? It's all part of that story where we're trying to democratize AI, right? We want to make AI available to every industry, every use case. And so one of the things we've worked really hard at in cognitive services and in the Applied AI org, which really is all about pre-built machine learning models and making them accessible to you in the form of services, web services, SDKs, and now containers. So now we leverage Docker containers in order to deploy this technology so that you can use this where you need it. Often we refer to this as the intelligent edge, right? Edge computing is all about, you know, having wherever your data is, putting the compute or the processing as close to that data as possible, as opposed to having to travel the network in order to do any of that work and any of that processing. So recently, An announcement was made that identified all of the containers that we've released. Now, we have lots and lots of pre-built models. These are the ones that are available today. We'll be consistently releasing them over time. But today we have text analytics. And if you look at text analytics, inside text analytics, you'll be able to do key phrase extraction and language detection and sentiment analysis. I often, again, kind of going along with that space analogy, you might imagine, you know, being able to do this against maybe logs, right? Like the captain's log that's being done or astronaut logs, and being able to do things like, oh, well, we're identifying a trajectory that maybe is identifying some loneliness or some depression, and being able to correct that and have, based on those patterns, identified ways to help people in space. I love space, as most of you know, so I just kind of will go with that for a little bit. Like face detection, again, oftentimes with these logs that astronauts do, I don't know if you've watched, but there's lots of different astronauts that post videos and updates on Twitter, and it's just super exciting to watch them from space. But it's also great to have the opportunity to analyze that data and even analyze it in space and have AI provide recommendations to them about what they're seeing. So you get face detection, verification, and emotion detection, all things that are pretty interesting. So we've got the ability to analyze text. Now we've got the ability to analyze faces. We also have the ability to just recognize text. Now this is important in the case that, again, let's say they're taking notes or maybe taking pictures of documents or something, and you're in a remote location, like Iceland or in a country that doesn't have consistent internet. Wouldn't it be great for you to be able to document and take pictures of things and be able to have that text pulled from that information, like those images, right? So being able to detect and extract printed text from any of these images, no matter where you are on the planet, using any device that you can deploy this container to, really expands what you're going to be able to do with this technology. Then, of course, we have computer vision, the ability to just use computer vision to do image and video analysis at the edge, as well as recently launched language understanding, being able to create language, use language models at the edge on devices. I often, again, see this in places where we want to, we don't have a consistent internet or connection, or maybe we're in a third world country and we want to be able to help, process or provide a spoken language interface to make it easier for people who don't have technology to get access to that technology or what it can provide. These containers enable that to happen. So there's so much good that can come from being able to do this. Lots of opportunity in your businesses to be able to do this. But I do want to point you, I'll put this link in the notes, but a blog was written and it actually has a list of all the containers, a little description, but most importantly, the links, not only to how do you, you know, configure the container, what is a container, but then also the step-by-step. I mean, each one of these steps are different per model. We're going to spend some time in future episodes going through and building some of these models on the edge. And it would be really cool. We'll see what kind of devices, maybe if you have some suggestions on the devices we might use, like put it in the comments. It would be really cool to use your ideas and do some fun experiments here on the show. But you'll be able to, through this link, go in, see all the different examples that we have, go in and build your own containers and be able to deploy them and see just how easy it is today to deploy a pre-built machine learning model to the intelligent edge. Really exciting stuff. Thanks so much for joining us this week, and I'll see you next time.